All right, I'm just going to put it out there. I absolutely love Lightroom's masking panel, and I'd argue that it is, pound for pound, the most powerful tool in the entire app. And it's not just because I can use these masking tools to make selective edits to certain parts of my photos, although that is at the heart of why these tools rock. The reason why Lightroom's masking tools are so powerful is because of how you can combine multiple masks together to apply unique effects in ways not possible using the global editing tools. And I'll go a step further. It's not about the ways that you can combine masks together, but rather things get really fun when you remove sections of one mask from another. The ability to add, subtract, invert, and intersect multiple masks is what gives this panel its power, and I'm going to show you one of my favorite ways to do that. Now, be sure to stick around till the end of this video because I've also got a really exciting announcement that I want to share. All right, let's dive in. All right, so if I had to summarize the specific masking trick that I'm going to show you, it is the ability to have your subject stand out from the background. Now, what I mean by that is oftentimes I'll take photos, especially at night or when it's dark, and it's hard for the subject to kind of pop off from the background because of everything being dark. And so this technique, I've used this a lot of times, especially in very subtle ways, and it helps make your subject pop off. So this works great with buildings or animals or people, especially people. And I'm going to show you two examples here, one with a building, one with a person, to have it kind of pop off from the background in a subtle but creative way. So here's what I'm talking about. You can see this photo of a church that I took in Slovenia several years ago. And it's funny, I had literally one photo. I got one photo of this church with the lights on before they turned off because this was sunrise. This was the beginning of the day. As soon as I took the photo, these lights were turned off and they don't turn on again until the next day. And I was already leaving the country. So I was really grateful to have this photo. But you can see how the building kind of blends in with the background because everything is dark. And so what I want to do is I actually want to kind of act as if there was some sort of a light or a glow behind the building to separate it from the background. And so we're not doing any edits here aside from using the masking panel. And if I go here to the masking panel, you can see I already have just a linear gradient that I applied, and that's just to kind of darken the top of the frame coming down here. I added a little bit of a dehaze to the clouds to make the sky a little bit more pronounced. But all it's doing here, as you can see, is it's just kind of bringing focus further down. It's aiding in that focus. But now again, what I want to do is I want to separate the church building from the background. So how will we do this? Well, I'm going to start by creating a new mask, and we're going to use a radial gradient. And so with a radial gradient, what you do is you click on the image and you drag and you create a general shape. And the shape of this radial selection will determine kind of the glow. So the first thing is the shape itself. That's one thing you want to consider. If you kind of hover over here, you'll see what that shape looks like. And then the other thing you'll want to consider is the feather. So if I enable the overlay so we can see it persistently, you can see if I take the feather slider and bring it to the left, I get a very hard edge, which I don't want. I actually want a soft edge. I don't always recommend using like a super soft feather. So I usually will start somewhere around halfway, and then I'll adjust accordingly. So I think a feather of 50 is a good starting point. All right, let's turn the overlay off. And now it's time to add the glow effect. So I think a lot of people veer towards using like the exposure slider where they increase exposure to add the glow, or maybe highlights. But I don't recommend that because the exposure slider tends to be a bit too abrupt. You can see how it's actually increasing the luminance values of those pixels in an unnatural way. So I'm going to undo that. My recommendation, if you ever want to add a glow of any sort, is to go and find the dehaze slider and then use a negative dehaze. So I'm going to go ahead here and apply a negative dehaze, and you can see how it actually looks like a natural glow. In fact, it looks kind of like mist is being added or fog in between the tree line. But the problem is that this dehaze, this glow, is also applying to the front of the church. I'm actually going to make this super strong so we can visualize it. So there. So you can see that it's covering the church, which is exactly what we don't want. I want to separate the church from the background. So here's where things get fun, and this is where the power of Lightroom's masking tools come in, because I can control the masks, how they interact with each other with these buttons, add and subtract, as well as invert and intersect. But for the case of this example, what I want to do is I'm going to subtract. So let's go ahead here. I'm going to click on subtract. And what I want to do is I want to subtract or remove from this selection. Now, there are different ways that you can remove one selection from another. You can try using the adaptive subject selection. You can use a brush. Or in my case here, I like objects. I think objects does a phenomenal job. So I'm going to click here. And you have two options here of how you can select the object. You can either just use a brush or you can use a marquee tool. So I'm going to use the marquee tool here. And I'm just going to make a selection around the structure here. And then you can see now how Lightroom did a wonderful job of removing the structure from the existing radial mask. Now, again, this doesn't look good because I have the dehaze strength so high. So I can go ahead here and I can bring this more towards center. And now you can see how even around here, it kind of looks like a really nice background glow. Now, don't forget, we can refine the shape of this glow. I made it really, really wide. So if I go to the radial gradient here, I can choose to kind of contract the glow. I can make it a little bit shorter and a little bit narrower, but you can see now that we have a much more defined glow. Now, the other thing is that the glow is kind of spilling onto the hill in front of the church, which we don't want. So again, this is where subtract comes in. I'm going to click on subtract, and this time I'm just going to use a brush. Let's turn the overlay on, and I'm just going to make a big brush here, and I'm just going to remove the existing selection from the foreground. So right around there. And you don't have to be so precise about it. I just don't want it spilling onto the front here, this little hill. So let's turn the overlay off. And now you can see how the glow is behind the church. It's also kind of behind this mound, which is really cool. And there are a few other things we can do in terms of controlling the characteristics of that glow. I'll go ahead here and I'm going to go to the temperature here. So maybe I want to simulate kind of like that orange light here. So I can warm that up and you can see how it kind of looks like there is one of those lights behind the church, illuminating the church. I can adjust the saturation as well if I really want to intensify it. Now here's one other tip that I have. Go ahead here and make the dehaze slider stronger. And the reason for that is what you can do if you want is don't overlook that there is an amount slider here for this mask. This is kind of like a strength slider or an opacity slider. So watch, if I bring this down, I'm kind of reducing the strength. So you can really refine it or you can make it super strong. But here, I'm going to kind of keep it like that. I'm also going to go back to the radial gradient here and I'm going to increase that feather. I want it to be a softer feather. And so now if I kind of toggle, you see how just natural, it looks really cool, that glow over there right behind the church. I'm going to go ahead and actually make this a little bit less strong. Yeah, that looks really good. And then I'm going to go ahead here. I'm going to rename this. I'm going to call this church glow, just so that I know that this mask is for that glow. And that's how you can get creative with how you interact one mask with another. Again, add, subtract, invert, and intersect. Those are your friends. And so I'm going to show you one more example. It's the same basic principle, but it's going to be of a portrait photo. And it should illustrate again how powerful it is when you want to separate your subject from a dark background. Okay, so here you can see I have this portrait photo and I want to do the same thing. I want to add a glow behind this person here just to have her kind of separated from the background. So just like before, let's go to masking here. We're going to select the radial gradient and I'm just going to make a nice big selection here. You can turn the overlay on again if you want to see kind of where the glow will be. And again, you can reposition this after the fact. But again, if we do anything right now, if I turn the overlay off and if we go to dehaze and I apply a negative dehaze, it's adding that effect to the person in the photo, which I don't want. So again, what we're going to do is we're going to go to subtract. And there are, again, a few different options here. You can either select subject, in which case Lightroom will analyze the image and make a subject selection. You can also use another form of an adaptive mask, which is this person mask here. And this actually does a really good job. I can see it right now. And so if I click on this, the next thing that I'll have to do is I want to make sure that the entire person is selected. I don't want to select the individual components. I just want the entire person to be masked. And then I'll click on subtract. Now you can see if we hover over, there's our glow. So let's go ahead here. Let's add a little bit more of that negative dehaze. And this time what I want to do is I want to kind of counter the warm color, the warm tone in the foreground. And so I'm going to take the temperature slider and I'm going to drag it to the left. And then I'm also going to increase the saturation. And so it kind of gives this almost like a blue glow behind her. And I think it complements the image really nicely. And so what I can do is I can reposition this if I want. So if I want it to be kind of more biased towards her head, I can do that, which I think I will. And I'm going to make it a little bit narrower and bring it down just a little bit. So like that. That looks really good. If you want to make the glow a bit more pronounced as well, another thing you can do is add a negative contrast, and that'll soften it. Because if you increase it, it actually adds contrast to the glow, which makes it a little bit reduced in its overall effect. And then again, don't forget that you can use the amount slider to control the overall strength of this mask. So you can dial it back and slowly build it in right around there. Looks really good. All right, so let's rename this. I'm a big fan of naming each of the masks. So we'll call this Portrait Glow. And you can see here, just does a really nice, it's very subtle, but it does a really nice job of separating the person from the background. And it just adds a nice visual effect to the photo. All right, so that should just illustrate to you just a small snippet of how powerful Lightroom's masking tools are. And that's actually what I'm so excited about to announce, because I just released a brand new course called Lightroom Masking Essentials. I've spoken to a lot of photographers over the years, and without a doubt, Lightroom's masking panel is the most confusing and intimidating for a lot of photographers, which is why I built this course. It's got over 3.5 hours of easy paced lessons, and it dives into every single tool within this panel, and it'll teach you the different ways that you can interact one mask with another. It covers Lightroom Desktop, Lightroom Classic, Lightroom Mobile, and Lightroom Web. So regardless of which version of this app you're using, you'll learn something. And by the end, you will have a mastery of how to use Lightroom's masking tools. So I've got a link to the course in the description below. I hope you check it out. Your support is always greatly appreciated. Now, another important component to Lightroom's power is its ability to use presets and profiles. And I've got a video right here that will help you with that as well. As always, if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.